Welcome back to a new video about a new function in LINQ. Today I will show you how to use skip function in LINQ. Skip function is to ignore a specified number of elements in a sequence, and it returns the remaining elements. The structure of this function is as follows. I set the function and then in brackets I write a number. This number indicates how many items I want to skip. For example, if we have a data table as output from the query, which contains 5 rows. I want to get all rows, except the first 2 rows. In this case, I can use this function with number 2, to get all rows from the result table, except the first 2 rows. Before I start explaining the function in UiPath, let me show you this example to understand the function better. Assume I have the following integer array, which contains 10 numbers, from 1 to 10. And I have this simple query. This query is to loop through all numbers in this array. It checks if the number is greater than 2. Then it selects all numbers, which meet this condition. Until this point the output is of type, IEnumerable. Assume I want to get the output as array. In this case I will add the function to array, to get the output as array. The result of this query is as follows. As you see, we have the following 8 numbers, which are greater than 2. Assume I don't want to get all 8 numbers, but only the last 6 numbers. In this case I can use skip function to ignore the first 2 numbers from the result, so that I get only the last 6 numbers. We can do that using the function skip. Skip is as mentioned to ignore a specified number of elements. So I will use the function as follows. As you see I added the number 2, because I want to ignore the first 2 numbers, which meet the condition. The result now is the following. We only have these 6 numbers as result. As you see, I use the function skip after the query. In this way I've filtered the output of the query. But we can also use the function to filter the data within the query. Let's see the following query. I have again the same array, and the following query. I first have from statement, where I use the function skip. What happens here in the statement? We skip the first 6 items in the array. The first 6 items. It means, the array now has only these last 4 numbers. After that we do the steps in the query for only these numbers. I have here again the same condition. The result in this case is the following. We have these 4 numbers as output, because all these numbers meet the condition. I mean they are greater than 2. These are the 2 ways how to use skip function in a LINQ query. In summary, we can use skip function to ignore a specified number of elements. Either after the query, to filter the output. Or within the query to filter the content. That's all about skip function. Now I will switch to UiPath to show you different examples. The first example is about reading the lines from a text file using LINQ query. I will use skip function in the query. Let's start. I have the following text file, which contains these lines. I want to read all lines from this file using a LINQ query. There are 20 lines in this file. I want to read all lines from this file, then I want to skip the first 5 lines. It means, I want to get only 15 lines from this file. The last 15 lines. Let's see how to do that. I will first add an assign activity to write the query. I will create a variable, to store the lines from the file. It should be of type list string, because we have a list of lines. It's not a default type, therefore I have to browse for it as following. Now we have a variable of type list string. Let's start writing the query. We have first a statement to read the lines from the text file. Here I defined a variable line, then I used this function to read all lines. In the brackets I added the text file path. You can also use a variable instead of the path here. After that I select each line from this file. At the end I converted the output of this query to list. So this query is to read all lines from the file, without filtering them or do anything here. So we don't have any conditions or something else. I will use skip function later. Let's first add for each loop, to print all lines in the output console. I will use the list variable here. And I will change type argument to string, because we have string type in the list. Let's add write line activity to print the content of the list. Now I will run to check if we get all lines from the file. As you see, we have the following result. We have 20 lines from the text file. So it works fine. Let's now edit the query and use skip function to skip the first 5 lines. Skip function now will skip the first 5 elements from the result of the query. It means we get all lines from the query as output. After that we skip the first 5 elements. As result we should get only 15 lines. The last 15 lines. Let's run it again to check the result. As you see, we have now only 15 lines. From line 6 to line 20. This is how to use skip function in a LINQ query. Let's now move on to the next example. Now I will use the same query to get all lines from the file. But I want to do some calculations for the lines after reading them. I want to use regular expression in the LINQ query. I will also use skip function. Let's first see what I want to do exactly. As you see, the text file has always a number at the end. I want to replace the number with a new number. The new number should be the old number multiple 2. For example, the line number 10 should be in the result as following. Instead of 10 I want to write 20, which is 10 multiple 2. Or for example, the number 15 should be 30, which is 15 multiple 2. And so on. I will do it for each line. Let's see how to do that. I will first edit the query, then I will explain it. Let's explain the query in detail. First we have the same old statement, where we read all lines from the text file. Then we have the following regex. I use this pattern to get the number from the line. For this I use the line variable, which is defined in the first statement. For this regex I use the method matches to get all matches from the line. The result will be stored in the variable x, which I defined here in the query. Then we have another variable y, to replace the old number with a new number. Here I use the variable line with the function replace. For replace function we have 2 parts, the old value and the new value. For the old value I use the following statement. What does it mean exactly? X is the variable, where I store the found numbers from the line. X is of type IEnumerable match, which contains different elements in the result. For example, if the line contains more than one number, we have more than one element in the result. But if the result contains only one number, then we have also only one element in the result. Let's see the following line for example. We have in this line only one number, 12. It means, x variable has now only one element. This number is stored in index 0. It means it's in the first index. To get this element, we use the variable x with the property item and the index 0. In this way I get the element what I need, which is the number 12. And so on I can get the element I need. I know in my case, that I only have one number, therefore I always use the index 0. But if we have more than one number in the line, we have to change the statement to get the correct number. For example, if we have this line, which contains 2 numbers. The x variable contains 2 elements. The first one has index 0 and contains the following number. The second one has index 1 and contains the following number. After that I use the same statement to get the value as integer number. And now I will add multiple 2 to multiply the found number by 2. After that I convert the number after multiplying to string. This part is the new value, what I want to set instead of the old value. I will also change the number in skip function to 8, because I want, for example, to skip the first 8 lines. The last thing we have to do here, is to change select statement. Here we selected line variable, but now we have to select y variable, because the new line after replacing the number is stored in y variable. Therefore we need to select y variable, not line variable anymore. And the statement is ready now. Let's run the code to check the result. As you see, we have now only 12 lines, because we skipped the first 8 lines. And we have new numbers in the lines. Not more the old numbers, but new numbers after multiplying them. For example, the first line in the result is the line number 9. It has now the number 18, which is 9 multiple 2. And the last line is number 40, which is 20 multiple 2. That's all about skip function in LINQ. And also how to use regex within a LINQ query. I hope you enjoyed the video, and could learn something new and interesting. If you have any questions or ideas, please let us know. We are happy to help you as we can. See you in the next video about another function in LINQ. Have a good day.